हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, जय हिंद टू ऑल। दिस इज विवेक श्रीवास्तव सर एंड आई एम हियर फॉर क्लास 7 जियोग्राफी एंड द टॉपिक दैट इज टू बी डिस्कस टुडे इट इज लाइफ इन टेम्परेट ग्रास लैंड। ओके, इस रिलेटेड टू क्लास 7 जियोग्राफी। सो बेटा, लेट अस स्टार्ट द टॉपिक। फर्स्ट वी हैव टू नो दैट व्हाट आर प्रेरीज। ओके, so there are certain parts of the earth where grasses are main vegetation and not the trees. It means only the grasses are vegetation there, where there are no trees available. It is estimated that about 1/4 of the total land surface is covered with grass. However, even in the grassland, the type of plants that grows vary. You may wonder why. It is because the variation in climate and the soil condition. Okay, we know that the climate condition vary from region to region. Thus, we have temperate grasslands and tropical grasslands. The temperate grasslands are known by different names in different areas, like the prairies in America and the wilds in South Africa. So first we will know about the prairies that is in North America. So what are prairies? Prairies are the grasslands that cover parts of United States of America and parts of Canada. In this region, one can observe tall grass up to 2 meters high. Okay, the heights of the grasses are up to 2 meters. Okay, so this region is therefore called sea of grass. Do you know the word prairies comes from the Latin word priata, which means meadow. The prairies region is a flat land, sometimes one can sloping or hilly had also. Prairie means that is sloppy or a hilly land. Okay, however, towards the low lying plains where tributaries of Mississippi and the tributaries of Saskatchewan drain. Okay, so some woodlands are found. It means where the tributaries of Mississippi River and Saskatchewan drain meet, there are some trees available. So cities like Chicago, Minneapolis, Indianapolis, Kansas and Denver are in the American prairies region. Cities like Edmonton, Saskatoon, Calgary and Winnipeg are in the Canadian prairies region. Clear? So now what are the climate condition over there in the prairies? The climate of prairies region is continental type. During summer, the temperature is very warm. It is about 20 degrees Celsius, while during winters, the temperature goes down to minus 20 degrees Celsius. During the winter, one can find a blanket of snow covering this region. Rainfall is moderate in this area. This helps the grass to grow. A local wind called Chinook blows here. Just mind it, the local wind that is known as Chinook blows in the prairies region of North America. Okay, now flora and fauna. What are the flora and fauna condition at there? So the major vegetation of the prairies region is grass. The region is almost treeless. It means very less trees are available in that region. In some places, however, trees like willow, elders and poplars grow. Farming is practiced in places that receive rainfall over 50 cm. Peoples here grows like maize, potato, cotton, soya bean, and alfalfa. Cattle rearing is done in area where the rainfall is very little. There are large cattle farms called ranches. These ranches are looked after by the cowboys. American buffalo are bison. American buffalo named as bison is found in this region. One can find other animal like rabbits, coyotes, prairie dog. Okay, so not bison and North American gopher. Clear? So that is the condition of the prairies, climate and flora and fauna. What are the people of the prairies? It means how are the people of the prairies? It means the citizens of that region. The people of prairies are industrious. Their hard work had made the region industrially developed. The people here practice agriculture using the most scientific method of cultivation. As a result, a region has a surplus wheat production. Okay, this region is also called granaries of the world, as there is a huge production of wheat because of grassland. Dairy farming is another major industries which people have chosen in this region. The entrepreneurs of this region have set up many food processing industries. The region is industrially very developed, but due to availability of mineral resources like coal and iron, people have developed good means of transport like roadways, railways, waterways and airways. So that is all about the condition of prairies in North America. In the next video, I will describe you the winds of South Africa. Till then, have a nice day. Thanks for watching me.